Okay, so today we will start the foodborne infection. That is the next topic in our chapter first. So today we will discuss what are the foodborne infections and what are the diseases which are going to be caused from the foodborne infections. So let's start. So in this unit, what we are going to learn about, basically we will learn what are the foodborne illnesses. Then we will also learn the classification of the foodborne illness. Then after that, we will also learn what are the dangers from the foodborne illness. Why the children are at higher risk than the adult or the young. And we will also try to learn what are the causes of the foodborne illness. So these are the things which we are going to learn in the chapter. In this chapter, now you can see on your screen how the foodborne diseases are going to be caused. So what is going to be happen if you are taking a food which is having certain bacterial growth, and if you are taking into your stomach. When you take the food into your stomach, it will start poisoning and your guts and your intestine are not able to digest it properly. Then in the next step, what is going to be happen? Like, it can be transferred from to bacteria, or it can be transferred from your hazardous food also. So foodborne disease results from the consumption of that particular contaminated. So the contaminated can be your physical, chemical and biological. It can be your pathogenic bacteria. So the pathogenic bacteria include your aflatoxin, mycotoxin, Clostridium botulinum, and all these things we will study properly one by one in the subsequent unit. So we will also learn what are the parasites which are going to cause this, and we will also learn what are the natural toxins which are going to cause the poison in the mushrooms. So these are particularly examples related to the foodborne diseases. For example, your mushroom is there which can also cause the poisonous if it will not find a proper time and temperature combination. There is a chances of growth of the poison or the particularly bacteria which will cause the foodborne disease. Now the etiology of the foodborne diseases. So foodborne diseases are those diseases that are result from the exposure to the pathogenic microorganism such as bacteria, virus, parasites, and which tend to have the acute effect on the human health. So like, foodborne diseases are going to be caused with this particular cycle. Now what is the foodborne diseases? So we have discussed the definition. It can be caused by your bacteria, it can be caused by your viruses, it can be caused by the parasite, and it can also be caused from the acute effect on the human health. So these are the particular effects which are going to cause the foodborne diseases. But however, the chronic and the acute, there is a difference between the chronic and the acute. Acute is something which is for the lesser period of the time, and chronic disease comes into the picture when it is going to cause the for longer period of the time. So we will try to understand in the presence of the various chemical substance or the pesticide residue or veterinary drugs, it can cause the problem of the foodborne diseases. So you have to remember these things. For example, certain food additives are there which are unlawful and which are not generally recognized as safe. They used to sell into the market, and these food firms are going to add it into the food product, which will cause a problem to the consumer or the customer. Now next is your mycotoxin. Mycotoxin is particularly related with our fungus. Okay, they are going to release this mycotoxin, and which is very harmful for the human and animals also. Then these are all the things which can be maybe intentionally or unintentionally. So whenever all these things are going to be added intentionally or unintentionally in our food item, then we will say it's a foodborne disease. And it can be your chronic, means longer period of the time, and it can be your acute for the shorter period of the time. So what are the problems? Due to the consumption, of the contaminated food, its detrimental effect on the human health. So you can find so many kind of your problems, like your dizziness, like your headache, muscle pain, etc. So what are the dangers for the individual and how it can be established? So at the individual or the human level, there are certain losses for the family income, because once a person is going to be hospitalized, they have to bear the certain minimum amount for the hospital, tablets, medicines, etc. Then cost of the special dietary need is required, means the person or the individual is not rely on the traditional food or the food which is served in our home. So they have to give the special dietary needs. Next is your death or funeral expense. This is very obvious. Now, how can we stabilize this? This can be stabilized with the loss of the customer or the sales, and increase the insurance premium, and lower the employee morale, and increase the employee turnover. So these are the things from which we can stabilize again a person who suffered from the foodborne illness. Now, event of the foodborne diseases. Foodborne event diseases can be in the following steps. So whenever the reservoir of the pathogen is coming from the food item, it is going to contaminate our food. And once it is going to contaminate our food, there is a chances of the growth. That growth can be a lag phase or log phase, or might be stationary phase, depending on the time of contamination. So when it is going to be contaminated, further it is going to be food with the live cells. Means a person is going to consume this food at this stage. Food is also included with these live cells. And when it is going to be further increased in our gut or in our intestine, then it is called as the infection. Now next step would be your, this is one of the example of the intoxication. In the intoxication, what is going to be happening? We are taking the toxin itself in our food item. And the next step is your intoxication. So you have to remember what is the difference between infection and intoxication. In infection, we are taking the live cell. In intoxication, we are taking the toxin which is already present by the live cells. Now, what is the classification of the foodborne disease? We will learn. So, first is your foodborne infection. So, I already told what is foodborne infection. Foodborne infection means they are going to take the live microorganism with their food. So, entrance of the pathogenic microorganism which contained into the food. So, in food itself, these particular borne microorganisms are present. And what they will do, they will not only increase the body temperature, they will also having a longer incubation of the period. When they have a longer incubation of the period, it means the chances of the infection in our body is higher. When the infection side is higher, it means the person has to tolerate the particular intoxication for a longer period of the time. And this resistance is completely dependent. What is the age of the person, what is the gender of the person, and what is the immunity of that particular person. So foodborne disease is completely rely or dependent on multiple factors. Now second is your foodborne intoxications. In foodborne intoxications, I already told what is going to be happening. We are taking the toxin with the food, like mycotoxin. So we are going to take the toxin with our food, and it will cause the consumption from the consumption and biotoxicant and metabolic product and poisonous substance. So these are the things which can act as a toxicant, like food biotoxicant, for example mycotoxin, metabolic products and poisonous substances. Now we will learn what are the main causes of the foodborne diseases. So three things are there which can be a possibility, like your cross-contamination. Cross-contamination, the word itself is saying it is going to be contaminated from one item to another, or from one surface to another surface, or from food to surface. So it can be reduced with the help of the good manufacturing practices and good hygiene practices in the plant. So what is going to be happen? We can reduce the cross contamination from the surface where it is going to be manufactured and where it is going to be packed. Second is your time temperature abuse. What happens like if a particular bacteria is going to be get a particular range of the temperature for some time, then the chances of growing of the bacteria is higher. As you know, that time and temperature can be a lethal dose for the microorganism also. So there are basically three kinds of your bacteria which can be classified: psychophilic bacteria, mesophilic bacteria and thermophilic bacteria. Psychophilic bacteria are generally survive less than 10 degrees Celsius. Mesophilic can be survived between 15 degree to 25, and thermophilic can be survived up to 45 degrees Celsius. So according to the temperature zone, the bacteria can be survived. Now next cause is your personal hygiene or poor personal hygiene. So in the plants, when a person is going to handle, or a labor or a worker is going to handle this product, if their hand is not sanitized, if their hands are not clean, or they are not wearing the gloves, then there is a chances of the contamination from their hand surface to the food. So it can be also be taken into the consideration. Now next is your types of food contaminations. So basically there are three kinds of your contaminants. First is your biological contaminants, second is your chemical contaminants, and third is your physical contaminants. Biological contaminants may be caused from the foodborne illness like your bacteria, virus, fungi, parasite, biological toxin. There are certain examples like seafood toxins, mushroom toxins. So whatever it is going to be originate from the biological thing like your bacteria, virus, fungi, parasite, they will be under consideration of the biological contaminants. Next is your chemical contaminants. The chemical substance can be caused the foodborne illness substance normally found in the restaurant. So these are the substances which going to be come into the picture with the help of the fertilizer, with the help of the pesticide residue, and these are the big problems. Next is your physical contaminant. So these are your foreign bodies, for example hair, staple wire, dust. So these are the basically three things from which the contaminants can come into our food: biological, chemical and physical. Now what the biological contaminants include? So we will look the biological contaminants. First of all, we will look the bacteria, because bacteria are the highest number of the microorganisms which are present in our food. So the example of the bacteria is your botulism, E. coli infection, salmonellosis, shigellosis, listeriosis, staphylococcus illness. So these are the major one bacteria which is causing the contaminant in our food. So you have to remember the name of the botulism, then Escherichia coli, salmonellosis, shigellosis and listeriosis. Now coming to the viral infections like hepatitis A, norovirus virus and rotavirus. So these are particularly three viruses from which the biological contaminants happen. For fungal we have yeast and mold, and for parasite we have three things. We will also take these things. First is your giardiasis, second is your cyclosporiasis, and third is your trichinosis. So we will discuss one by one all these contaminants. Now disease caused by bacteria. So this is one of the picture which is given, like how the microorganisms are going to be spread. Particularly this is the example of the Gallonella. Now first coming to the botulism. How the botulism is going to be affected our human body and how it is originated. So you can see in the picture the normal muscle tissues are there, and how this botulism is going to adhere with the muscle tissue. So this bacteria Clostridium botulinum is a bacteria which is giving the intoxication botulism. Or botulism is a spore forming bacteria. It's an anaerobic bacteria, means it does not require the oxygen. Then organism produce a neurotoxin, means the toxin botulism directly going to affect our system, which is the neurotoxin system. Now types of the illnesses, it can be a like onset period for 12 to 36 hours, means after infected a person, the symptoms will come into the picture after 36 hours or between like 12 hours to 36 hours. Now what are the symptoms? The symptoms include your dizziness, it includes your double vision, means the person is not able to look properly. Breathing problem can also be come, means the person is not able to take proper amount of the oxygen into lungs, and swallowing problem. Now what are the sources from which this bacteria or the botulism is going to cause a problem? First is your improperly caned food item, means the caned food item is not retorted properly. Second is your vacuum packed item, and third is your refrigerated food. So these are the things. Now how the botulism is going to adhere with our body? So you can see the picture. These red color are of your botulinum toxin, and these yellow color are your normal muscle tissue. So you can see how these toxin compounds are going to adhere with our acetylcysteine. Okay, and these are the nerve cells, and these are your snare protein. So you can find out how they are going to be adhere with our body. Now second is your E. coli infection. So how E. coli infection is widely distributed? First you can look into this graph. The wild avian species is going to cause the 52%. Then cattle cause it from 22%. Then human is around 8%. That is a very big fraction that human is going to be affected, 8% of the E. coli infection. So the bacteria name is your Escherichia coli, and it is produced as a Shigella toxin, and facultative anaerobic bacteria are there. Facultative anaerobic bacteria means if the oxygen is present, means they can able to tolerate. Now types of the illness, it would be your bacterial infection, because Escherichia coli is a bacteria. And the toxin which is going to cause a problem in our system or in our digestive system. So it's a bacterial infection. And the onset period is around 3 to 8 days. Onset period means the period whenever the person is going to infected and the symptoms is visible. So from 3 to 8 days or after 3 to 8 days, means in 5 days, there are chances that the symptoms can be visible. So what are the symptoms? How can we understand that now a person is going to affected from the E. coli infection? So these are the particular symptoms which a particular person is going to show, like bloody diarrhea, then following the kidney failure. Now what are the food sources? The food sources include your undercooked beef. Means the beef, whatever the person is going to be added and eat, is not going to be cooked properly. Then unpasteurized apple juice. Now how this unpasteurized apple juice, whenever the juices are going to be pasteurized, they have to be pasteurized at 90 degrees Celsius. But what happened? Certain pasteurizations are not take place properly because of not of the time temperature combination, because of the coldest point, means some of the juices are not able to reach that particular point or temperature. Next is your raw milks and dairy product. Now looking to the next one, next bacteria is your Listeria monocytogenes, and the toxin which is produced by it is your Listeriosis. So this is the bacteria which is going to be cause. Now what kind of the character which this particular bacteria have? It has the facultative anaerobic bacteria, means they can easily tolerate the oxygen, there's no problem. They are able to survive into high salt food. For example, your kurkure, for example, your chips, all these having the high salt, and certain kinds of the pickles are also there, and can grow at the refrigerated temperature. Means even if you have keep the food at your room temperature or at your room, particularly in your refrigeration section, and if the Listeria monocytogenes are there, you cannot suppose that it is going to be undertaken. It can be a possibility that they are surviving and they are growing there. Now, types of illnesses. It can be considered under the bacterial infection, and the onset time is 3 to 70 days. So there is a huge time gap difference between the infection and for the visibility of the symptoms in the listeriosis. Now, how can we know that a person is suffering from the listeriosis? So it can be a possibility he is suffering from headache. Second, it can be a possibility loss of balance, and it is particularly dangerous for the pregnant ladies. Now, what are the sources? The sources include your raw milk, means the milk is not pasteurized, or the milk is not heated properly at your home. Second, it can be come from the meat, whether it is meat, chicken meat, whether it is your beef meat. Then RTE is also the source of the listeriosis. Now, next is your salmonellosis. This is also one of the toxin, and it is produced by your salmonella bacteria. So what are the characteristics of the salmonella bacteria? It is a facultative anaerobic bacteria. That means they can tolerate the oxygen, no problem for them. Then fecal contamination. This is also a very big problem for the salmonellosis, because most of the time you can find where the milching has been done, the milk can come into the fecal contamination of particular animal. Now, types of the illness. The illness is your bacteria infection only, because it is infecting in our body only. Now, what are the symptoms? Its symptoms include, as you see in the picture, fever, nausea, diarrhea, the body of the temperature of the person will raise, loss of appetite, and vomiting and fever. So all these are the symptoms of your salmonellosis infection. Now, what are its food source? I told you as the fecal contamination can come from the soil, so that is one of the source. Second is your insect. Third is your raw meat. Then eggs, salad dressing. All these are the examples through which the food, the salmonellosis can be infected. Now, next one is your shigellosis. So, shigellosis is also a toxin which is produced by the bacteria Shigella. So, it is also a facultative anaerobic bacteria, means it can easily grow into our body where oxygen might be there or not be. And how they generally grow? They will grow in the colonized way, means they can grow in the colonies within the human intestine or the GI tract. And they can be spread from the polluted water, because polluted water is a big problem in our country. If you look to the BIS standard, Bureau of Indian Standard, it is found that most of the metropolitan cities having a problem of the bad water. And out of 28 or 29 tests, they generally passed only 2 to 3 tests. Now, what is the problem? Most of the metropolitan cities, people are getting infected from such kind of the disease from the water only. Now, type of the illness, it will cause an illness of the bacterial infection. Now, what are the symptoms? The symptoms include your diarrhea, fever, abdominal pain, and cramps. Now, dehydration can also be a possibility in the case of your shigellosis bacteria. And what are its food sources? Its foods are that are prepared by the human, salad, ready to eat meal. Now, coming to the next One, which is your Staphylococcus aureus. Staphylococcus illness can be occur commonly found in our human skin. It can be from hair, nose and throat also, and can grow in the high salt and high sugar. The type of the illness is bacterial intoxication. So be remembered, it is an intoxication. It means the toxin is already going into our food, not the bacteria. So be remember that Staphylococcus is going to cause the intoxication problem. Now what are its symptoms? Its symptoms are same like nausea, vomiting, abdominal pain, cramp. And what are its food sources? Its food sources include your leftover meat, egg and product potato and salads. So now we will discuss about the viruses. Now you can see the picture of the virus. The influenza virus is there, which is now commonly found in our COVID system also. So you can see what the influenza consists or a virus can consist. It consists of meta-RNA inside the its core, you can find this. Then there is a membrane also, and except that there is a protein coated layer, which is the outside one. So like viruses cause the foodborne diseases very less, but still there is a possibility. Now we will discuss about the hepatitis A. So hepatitis A generally caused by the virus Hepatovirus, and it is found in the human intestinal and the urinary tract. And it will be also a problem from the contaminated water also. So you can see, like if a person is suffering from the jaundice or hepatitis A, the person's eyes is going to be yellow. And its period may be of 2 to 10 days as a window period, means it will take 2 to 8 days, at least 8 days to show its symptoms. And food sources are your oysters and raw vegetables. So whenever the vegetables are coming at your home, you have to wash them properly. Now second virus is your Norwalk virus. So what is Norwalk virus? Its symptoms. Its symptoms are your nausea, vomiting, diarrhea, abdominal pain, headache and long grade fever. And what are its food sources? Its food sources your water, surface and contaminated water. Now coming to the next, which is our rotavirus. So this is the rotavirus which caused like the gastrointestinal problem. And it is particularly adhered with the children and the infant. And what are its symptoms? Its symptoms are your vomiting, low grade fever and water diarrhea. And it can be transmitted also from person to person or from animal to person also. So it can be contaminated through hand also or from one item to another surface. So these are the diseases which is caused by the fungi, as you can see the nails. So in fungi there is a mold, and mold is very important when it comes to the bakery item. So whenever the mold are going to be attached with the bakery item, the surface color is going to be changed. So as you can see in the picture, the surface of the bread has changed. So you can find out the bottom here. And here also the it convert into the green color, it convert into here into a blue color. So mold can spoil the food and causing the discoloration and unpleasant smell. So these are the two very important characteristics when a product is going to be have a mold growth, discoloration and unpleasant smell. And they produce a toxin which is related to your cancer and cause the allergies also. So we very take care whenever the molds are there. And in the mold, the aflatoxin is a toxin which is released by this mold. And aflatoxin is very crucial in the terms of our liver diseases. So we have to understand if a person is going to be having a problem of aflatoxin or intoxicated the aflatoxin, then there is a chance of the liver disease or liver infection for that particular person. Now that can be killed also if we will take 140 degrees Celsius for 10 minutes. Means the holding period can be at 10 minutes for 140 Fahrenheit of the temperature for the mold. And the toxin are heated at the stable and not be destroyed. So thank you for this. In the next class, we will discuss also regarding some of the physical and your chemical parameter. And if there is any doubt, please let me know. Then we will discuss the query section also. So just thank you so much.